Hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to learn a concept that's a quick ratio formula. Now, quick ratio by the name itself is liquid, basically liquid ratio formula. Now, there are two kind of ratios, current ratio and quick ratio. Current ratio accounts for at least the liabilities or the assets which are going to get materialized within the time span of 1 year. But what about the quick liquidity? So when we talk about quick liquidity, we talk about quick ratio. Now the quick ratio formula has the following formula, as it is quite stated over here. It is your cash, highly liquid, the short-term marketable securities, again highly liquid, and account receivables. So if you calculate for current ratio, you have all the current assets, but over here some of the current assets like stock has been removed, because stock cannot get converted into a liquid form in a very quick fashion. So cash, short-term market securities, and account receivable divided by current liabilities. So as you can see, no change in the liability. Let's try and learn how quick ratio works. See, the quick ratio formula, which is also known as the asset test ratio, and it is one of the most important liquidity ratio for determining the company's ability to pay off its current liability in a very short term. So basically, it goes by the formula of the quick ratio. That quick ratio means what we just discussed. It is your cash plus any short term marketable securities, plus you have to add, that is your debtors, that is your accounts receivable, divided by your current liabilities. Now, instead of this, you can also calculate your quick ratio something like this. Your quick ratio is equal to, now in case company is not giving the breakup of the quick assets, then in that particular scenario, you can calculate your quick ratio something like this. The total current assets, you need to deduct something from this, that is called the inventory, and you need to add here, that is prepaid expenses. So once you add, once you do this or incorporate things in the formula, you have your quick ratio. So divide by your current liabilities. Over here, you are just deducting your total current assets. Of that, inventory and prepaid expenses are not the liquid ones, so you're deducting that. And the rest is going to be the stated things which is right in front of us. Quick ratio example. Let's take an example on the same and understand. Let's say there's a company called Mastek Co, and it has following details, something like this. They have their current assets, and the detail of current assets is cash, which is $2 lakh. Then you have your advances. Okay, your advance, let's say, is $30,000, and there are some marketable securities, which is $60,000. Now, we have some more details, that is your accounts receivable, which is known as your debtors. Its value is, let's say, $40,000, and inventories, or you can say your stock, is $80,000. So this are some of the details for current assets. Now, your total current assets is going to be how much? Is equal to sum of all this value. That is your 4,10,000 is your total current assets. Now, let's talk about something, that is current liabilities. In case of current liabilities, let's put up some things over here. The accounts payable, which is also known as your creditors. Let's say it is $2,60,000. The accrual expenses, and this amounts to, let's say, $30,000. There is another item involved over here, is, let's say, short term debt, so which accounts to $90,000, and interest payable, which is, let's say, $60,000. Now, our total current liability will be which is 4,40,000, and over here 4,10,000,
right?
The previous year asset test ratio, I'm talking about the previous year asset test ratio, was let's say 1.4, and the industry average is let's say 1.7. so the calculation of the asset test ratio will be something like this. Your asset test ratio is equal to all the things that we mentioned: cash plus short-term marketable securities plus any accounts receivables, and you will divide this by current liabilities. So let's try and put this in numbers and get the answer. We have cash that is 2 lakh plus our marketable security 16,000 and accounts receivable as 40,000. So this is your quick ratio formula, is equal to, this is your total assets, and you need to divide this by your total liabilities, and your final quick ratio is going to be 3 lakh divided by 4,40,000. That's 0.68. so what we see is that the previous year's quick ratio was 1.4, but now it has reduced down to 0.68, which is not good. So let's understand how to interpret this ratio. So the quick ratio formula is like most stringent measure of the short term liquidity. Remember this thing. Now, as compared to the current ratio, now the quick assets are the ones which can be converted into cash in a short term, or you can say in a period of 90 days. Okay, the important difference between the current ratio formula and the quick ratio or asset test ratio formula is that we are excluding, that is something that is inventories over here, and any prepaid expenses. So because as a part of the current assets in the quick ratio formula, so inventory is excluded because it is assumed that the stock, you can say that stock is held by the company, may not be realized immediately. So the inventory could be in the form of any sort of like raw material, work in progress, or you can say the finished goods, and so on and so forth. So such a situation will make the process of the liquidating the inventory all the more tricky and time consuming. So an asset test ratio is considered as good if it is one or more. So you can say greater than one is better. So this is a benchmark that the company can pay off of its current liabilities with the help of the quick assets and without needing to sell off its long-term assets, and has a sound financial health. Care must be exercised in placing too much reliance on the asset test ratio without further investigating. Like, you know, there are things like a seasonal business, okay, which seeks to stabilize the production, might have a weak quick ratio formula during its period of slack sales, but you can say higher one in case of in the peak business season. So such a situation may prove tricky to know the actual financial position of the company. So what is the use of the quick ratio? So keeping the track of the quick ratio formula, it helps the management to determine whether they are maintaining the optimum level of the quick assets so as to take care of the short-term liabilities in their balance sheets. Second, quick ratio formula showcase a well-functioning short-term financial cycle of any company. And the third important is, you know, this improves the credibility of the company with the investor by gaining and maintaining the trust in the value of the investments. And also the creditors, you can say, of the company know their payments will be made on time.
If you have learned and, you know, liked the video, if you think that, you know, if you have enjoyed and learned watching this video, please like, comment on this video, and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.